Good morning. Welcome to our outdoor worship being held indoors this morning due to rain. Today is the 11th Sunday after Pentecost. Let us rise for the invocation and prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Everlasting Father, you have given your Son Jesus as the bread of life for the world. Increase our hunger for him and our commitment to take him to all who hunger until everyone knows the sustaining power of your love. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
This morning's scripture reading on the 11th Sunday after Pentecost is from the Old Testament. 1 Kings. Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah saying, "So may the gods do to me and more also if I don't make your life as the life of one of them by this time tomorrow." Then he was afraid and he arose and ran for his life and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a broom tree. And he asked that he might die, saying, "It is enough now, O Lord, take my life, for I am no better than my fathers." And he lay down and slept under a broom tree. And behold, an angel touched him and said to him, "Arise and eat." And he looked, and behold, there was at his head a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water, and he ate and drank and lay down again. And the angel of the Lord came to him again a second time and touched him and said, "Arise and eat, for the journey is too great for you." And he arose and he ate and drank and went in the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the mount of God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The epistle is from Ephesians chapter 4. "This I say and testify in the Lord, that you must no longer walk as Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. They are darkened in their understanding, alienated from the life of God because of their ignorance that is in them, due to their hardness of heart. They have become callous and have given themselves up to sensuality, greedy to practice every kind of impurity. This is not the way you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard about him and were taught in him as the truth is in Jesus, to put off your old self, which belongs to your former manner of life and is corrupt through deceitful desires, and to be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and to put on the new self, created after the likeness of God in true righteousness and holiness. Therefore, having put away falsehood, Let each one of you speak the truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be angry, but do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and give no opportunity to the devil. Let the thief no longer steal, but rather let him labor, doing honest work with his own hands, so that he may have something to share with anyone in need. Let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for building up, as fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. This is the word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel is recorded in St. John chapter 6. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst. But I said to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me I will never cast out. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who looks on the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. So the Jews grumbled about him, because he said, I am the bread of life, the bread that came down from heaven. They said, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How does he now say, I have come down from heaven? Jesus answered them, do not grumble among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they will all be taught by God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except he who is from God. He has seen the Father. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We join in professing our faith with Luther's explanation of the second article. I believe that Jesus Christ, true God, begotten of the Father from eternity, and also true man, born of the Virgin Mary, is my Lord, who has redeemed me, a lost and condemned person, purchased and won me from all sins, from death, and from the power of the devil, not with gold or silver, but with his holy precious blood, and with his innocent suffering and death, that I may be his own, and live under him in his kingdom, and serve him in everlasting righteousness, innocence, and blessedness, just as he is risen from the dead, lives and reigns to all eternity. This is most certainly true. You may be seated.
Thank you.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The words of our text for today recorded in the Old Testament reading from 1 Kings chapter 19, where it says, "Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah, saying, 'May the gods do to me and more also, if I do not make your life as the life of one of them by this time tomorrow.' And then Elijah was afraid, and he arose and ran for his life and came to Beersheba, which belongs to Judah, and left his servant there." Just a little background about the text. By this time, the nation of Israel had divided, with 10 tribes to the north and Judah to the south. Judah worshiped the true God, but Israel, the 10 tribes to the north, abandoned that worship and took on the worship of a false god, an idol named Baal. And at the time of this event, the king of the northern nation of Israel was King Ahab, and his wife, the queen, was Jezebel. Both of them were very wicked, very evil. So at this time, it was Elijah, the prophet of God, dealing with the false prophets of Baal. God worked out an incredible victory. It was amazing what God did through Elijah. And then right after that, with the false prophets of Baal being destroyed by Elijah, Queen Jezebel put a price on Elijah's head and decided he would have to be killed as well. So with that in mind, 60 years ago, I can't believe it, I went to my first Major League Baseball game. It's really amazing. It was a bus trip. I don't know who sponsored it. It could have been from the sub-base in Groton or something, because my dad was in the Navy, so he and my brother we all got on this bus to go see this professional baseball team. And it was exciting because this team had a hometown hero on the team. His name was Billy Gardner, who grew up in Waterford, Connecticut, a professional player. And everybody back then in Waterford knew of Billy Gardner. But there are other players on the team. In fact, back then, I knew the entire roster of this professional team. They had players like Bobby Richardson. Ring a bell? No. Cleet Boyer. No. Joe Pepitone. Oh. Yeah, you all are too young for that. How about Yogi Berra, Whitey Ford, Mickey Mantle, Roger Maris? I'll tell you, this was exciting to go to Yankee Stadium back then and see a real game and to see some of these heroes that sports fans truly love to follow. Because Mickey Mantle and Roger Maris, boy, they could hit home runs. And I couldn't wait to be at Yankee Stadium and see Mickey Mantle come up to bat and hit a home run. But it didn't happen. And you know what was really devastating? Is to watch Mickey Mantle strike out. As a young kid, that's not supposed to happen. He's a star. And he struck out. And neither of them hit a home run that day. I don't know who won the game. I can't remember that far back. But I can remember my disappointment at my heroes not performing as I had hoped. I look at Elijah almost with that same sense of disappointment. This is Elijah, who of all the prophets of God, all the other ones were in hiding for their lives. And Elijah stood up to King Ahab. Elijah stood up to the 450 false prophets. Elijah had courage. He knew that God was his strength. And right after it happens, what happens? He falls apart. He hears that Jezebel wants him dead. And he's afraid. That's not consistent with what you would expect from Elijah. He's afraid. He runs for his life. He's depressed. He drops off his servant, goes out into this barren area, lies down under a broom tree. And what does he say? He says, I've had enough. That's it, Lord. Just take me now. I don't want to face life anymore. That's it. I'm done. Have you ever felt that way? I mean, sometimes we do. When things in life seem to be against us, you have a bad day, a bad week. Things don't go the way you expect, and you just don't want to deal with it anymore. You want to just quit. And I've seen over the years people who just simply walk away from things because they don't want to deal with it anymore. Just like Elijah. Sometimes we just don't have the strength. Sometimes we just don't have the desire to fight anymore, to face things anymore. And we just want to give up. The good thing about Elijah is that God did not accept Elijah's resignation. And what I love about this, God didn't scold Elijah. He didn't say, come on, Elijah, what's your problem? Come on, get up off your pity couch and get going in life. He didn't do that. What he does is he sends the angel of the Lord, comes to him and brings him bread and water. You need to eat. He didn't tell him to wake up. Sometimes a good nap is good for us. And then a second time, the angel of the Lord comes to Elijah with more bread and more water. And he says, get up and eat, because the journey is too great for you. You know? And that same God can encourage us as well. He provides what we need for what we face in life. And even when we feel that we're facing something greater than what we want to deal with, we have a God who is greater than the problems we face. We can face anything with faith in our Lord. We may not get the results we're looking for, but we can be assured of that God will give us the strength to get through whatever we face, and he will bring whatever outcome that he has in mind. And our God doesn't scold us when we get discouraged or have the attitude we want to give up. Instead, he reminds us that he's there because we have a Lord, our Savior Jesus, who faced the greatest threats that anyone could ever face. He faced the devil being tempted in the wilderness when he was there for 40 days, 40 nights. And the devil threw everything he had in mind, fastballs, curveballs, you name it. But Jesus, he responded with home runs every time. And Jesus himself faced such opposition, even allowed himself to be arrested, nailed to a cross. But that was for the purpose of bringing to you and to me salvation. And he rose after, bodily, to life. That's our Savior. He didn't fail. He was never discouraged. He always put his trust in the will of his Heavenly Father. And even though he died, God raised him from the dead. And that's the Savior that you and I have. We might have days that don't go like we want. But in the end, we know we're in good hands. We're in a good place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. The altar flowers are given by Harold and Judy Kirchstein in honor of their 50th wedding anniversary, which was yesterday. And the eternal light is lit by the Brown family in memory of Joe and Phyllis Schlosser. Also in our prayers, we pray for those under the doctor's care. We continue to pray for Kaylee and Kathy and Tim Yaden, Dale Kirby's brother Neil. Michelle Brogy requested prayers of thanksgiving and continued prayers for a smooth recovery for their son Daniel, who was discharged this past week to being home again. From Sandy Boysford, prayers for Gary, a friend's nephew. And Judy Kirchstein requested prayers for Tammy, who is facing cancer treatments. Susan Brady requested prayers of healing and strength for Russ, Marguerite Terry, who is Jean's brother, and David, Joe, Dennis, and David. Tammy Lynn requested continued prayers for Dave, that his next scan shows improvement. And she is so grateful her mom is recovering and is coming home today. Thankful prayers to Jesus that she is continuing to get stronger. We pray for Janice Rolls, who is under the care of doctors, and for the family and friends of Steve LeClaire, who passed away last week. Our prayers are printed in your worship folder for today. Let us rise as we continue in prayer. Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life. You have invited us to pray about everything. We believe your promise to hear the prayers we offer in Jesus' name. We pray, Lord, that you would give us mercy and forgive our sins by which we have offended you. Lord, hear our prayer. Bring an end to quarreling and fighting among us and among the peoples of the earth. Give us grace to live together in peace. Lord, hear our prayer. Help us work and play in such a way that all our activities may bring honor to your name. Watch over the sick, the troubled, the lonely people of the world, and let them experience the strength and joy your Spirit gives. Give peace to our nation. Protect us from war and violence, and give us hope in times of disaster. Bless our church, our Sunday school and preschool, and all who serve in this place. Guard our homes and families with your love, and make us loving and considerate of one another. All these blessings we are bold to ask, because you have given us the greatest blessing of all, yourself. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Have a great week.